released their power rankings of top teams in the National Football League, and Drew Brees and the Saints came out number one, followed by the Chiefs, Rams, Patriots, and Chargers. Say, I'll start with you. You buying the New Orleans Saints as the best team in the NFL?
I got a lot of confidence in what the Saints are doing. If you look at where teams started out this year, and a person that we haven't mentioned, Dennis Allen, their defensive coordinator, because this defense has been much maligned through the years. But last year, they started off really, really slow. Their season was ended because of the Minneapolis Miracle. Did we forget that? Did we think, I mean, Nick and I talked about how a better matchup we thought
for
the
Philly.
Saints were
yeah.
last year for Philly than the Vikings were. Now, the Vikings in that game, I don't know who would have beat them with that crowd and everything, but that confidence, it just continued this offseason, what they're doing, their ability to be able to run the ball, pass the ball, give the ball, get anyone in the back. Tyson Hill coming off as a backup quarterback and the wrinkles they have, special teams-wise, they are strong. And also what we've seen with teams, because they have the number one rush defense, people think, well, people haven't been patient enough. Then they get in the game. It's kind of like the Buster Douglas, Mike Tyson in the game, and you start racing, trying to chase after the Saints offense. Mm-hmm. And then you don't run the ball. And the next thing you know, at the end of the day, you're like,
what happened?
We only have 14 carries. So I got a great deal of confidence in a guy also, because you're going to need to. You need to have one of these guys, a guy that can make three or four throws at the end of the game. And Drew Brees, I would love to be able to see him play Patty Mahomes or someone else like that. But when you talk about who can run the ball, who can stop the run, and who's got a guy that's pulling the trigger that you got that kind of confidence in, that's why I have the Saints as my best team in the NFL.
They're the team that I think people should have the most confidence in. And I'm going to use the word CUs because it's clear there's three teams that are better than everybody at the moment. Now, maybe the Chargers will get themselves in that discussion. The Patriots have been kind of grandfathered into it. But Saints, Chiefs, and Rams have been the cream of the crop all year. The Saints are the only of those three teams that I think can beat a good team on a day their offense is bad. Because they can beat you. They can beat you. They can grind it out on the ground, and they have a legitimate defense. I don't think the Rams can beat you if Goff and Gurley have an off game. I know the Chiefs can't beat you if Mahomes is bad, especially now that Kareem Hunt's gone. So the Saints are the team who I think don't have to be firing on all cylinders to win a playoff game. They, you know what I mean? If in their first.
What happened against that, in that Dallas game? That was a game where this Saints offense wasn't playing that well.
I'm not saying that they're going to win every game. And I'm not saying that they're unbeatable. I'm saying that Dallas game to me is almost the point I'm making. Their offense was as bad as it could be, and they were right there. Like, they were playing a great defense with a terrible offensive performance. But if the Chiefs had that offensive performance, because I think Chiefs offense is better than the Saints, but if the Chiefs had that offensive performance, it wouldn't be 13-10.
Right.
It'd have been 27-10 Dallas, and the Chiefs wouldn't have been in the game late. That's the distinction.
What makes the Saints team so good? What is it about them? Is it that they're a complete team, that they're so focused and so strong on both sides of the ball? What is it about this team that you have so much confidence in?
Well, for one, they have the organizational support. Like, this is a winning organization. Sean Payton, him and Mickey Loomis, man, Jeff Ireland, man, they're some of the best in the business as far as picking talent, picking the type of personalities, what they do for the players. They got one of the greatest quarterbacks of all time. Sean Payton, I believe, is underrated as one of the elite coaches we have in this game, and he's one of the great play callers. Also, Sean Payton's one of the great motivators. Of all the teams we have six teams listed. Sean Payton is the one coach besides Belichick that I know after the game I'm not going to say, did he forget to run the ball?
Mm-hmm.
So I have a lot of confidence in that. Andy Reid will get to the press box and be like, we only what? Yeah, you forgot to run the ball. McVay, I see that with Todd Gurley all the time. I'm wondering. I look at halftime, I'm like, why has Todd Gurley not touched the ball?
That was the Bears game.
So,
eight first half touches.
So I get concerned about that. Sean Payton relieves that. Sean Payton comes from, even though he's an offensive coach, he's mentored by Bill Parcells. And the things that he does in big game situations is far more dependable, and I like that.
And as Chris likes to remind us a little more often than I would like, there is no replacement for experience. And this team, like, you look at the other three teams, Jared Goff's played in one playoff game. Pat Mahomes never played in a playoff game. Drew Brees won a Super Bowl. You look at even the coaches. Sean McVay's coached in one playoff game. Andy Reid's got a lot of playoff experience. But Andy Reid, as good as they've been in Kansas City, he's won one playoff game since he was the Eagles head coach. So, like, if we're talking about coaching quarterback experience of the three best teams, Drew Brees and Sean Payton have it, have the other two teams trumped by far.
All right, so you got your Saints, Chiefs, Rams, Pats, and Chargers. Give me a team outside of the top five you like.
Listen, I think the Bears are dangerous. I think all they need is a game. I think they need Mitch Trubisky to have a Nick Foles type of six good quarters because the I think they can win a playoff game with a bad offensive performance, much like the Eagles did against the Falcons. I think they're not going to have the home field that the Eagles had. I think that defense is that good that if Trubisky is just competent and then catches fire for seven possessions, I think that's a dangerous team.
Because the Texans have such a good defense this year under Romeo Cornell, he's coming back running that after Bravo went on to be the head coach, and Deshaun Watson on that big stage. If you take his ability to be able to make plays, I'm concerned about their red zone offense. It's hard for me to believe that there's only two teams worse than them as far as red zone offense, but his dynamic playmaking ability, I'd like to see DeAndre Hopkins in the playoffs. We haven't been able to see that. So that combination, J.J. Watt, comeback player of the year, that force going against some of those teams in the AFC that are up and down.
And the Texans very alive for the two seed still, thanks to the Pats' loss this past weekend, despite their own loss. And one thing, if you look at Deshaun Watson, last year when he was great, turned the ball over a lot. The beginning of this year, first handful of games, turned the ball over a lot. When they've been on this winning streak, he has been as good as just about anybody in football, not throwing interceptions and still making big plays. That's part of his progression. That Texans team, offensive line, running game, and the red zone, I put on the coaching, the play calling, but they have a ton of talent, pass rush, quarterback, wide receivers.
All right, time to pay the bills. Got to take a break. Coming up, a Hall of Famer says the end is near for Tom Brady. Yep, that's what he said. That's next on First Things First.
Speaking of paying the bills, America, Jenna Wolf had me try to find an email for her one day, and I saw Jenna Wolf be cashing checks now.
Excuse me.
Hey, honey, just deposited.